citizens of this country, remind us, Lord, that our ultimate citizenship is in your kingdom, that as we live and work and serve in this country and in your world, our eyes may always be turned to you, waiting and watching for that day when Christ will come again with you. It is in his name we pray. Amen.
You all join me in singing the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see?
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm going to try something here because I'm not, me and microphones are not very compatible most of the time.
Can everybody hear me?
No.
You're fine.
All right, I'll go ahead and use the microphone. If you hear a squeal, it's either me getting very nervous or it's the microphone. I'm very, very pleased to see all the people here today. Does my heart very good. I'm sure it does every other veteran that attends this service. It makes us feel warm inside. At this point in time, I would like to thank everybody that put this together on behalf of every veteran in the community. Whether they're here or not, I'm here to say thank you. The second thing I want to do is recognize the veterans that are here. So if you have served in the military of the greatest nation under God, would you please take this time to stand and be recognized?
Another step.
age of community. The same community will greet you at the front door of the church. They'll see you on the sidewalk. They'll see you at the school. They'll see you in one of our different military processions, military funerals. Families and community work together, because even as we have been so lucky not to have had a fallen amongst us as this actual community, the possibility exists. And I'm sure that if, God forbid, something like that happened, we would all come together and be the community that I've grown to love and be very proud of. About the only other thing that I want to say today in reference to Veterans Day is that the original Armistice Day or whatever was created after World War I, and it was supposedly the war to end all wars. The sad part about that is it was wishful thinking on everybody's part. We have people in here from today that I see, recognize, and honor all the way back to World War II, and those numbers are getting fewer and fewer and fewer, by the way. So if you ever want to get a chance to hear a really good story, grab one of these old boys and let him tell you about his experience. Okay? The actual numbers are getting to the point where it's just a very, very lucky thing to even see any of them around. But unfortunately, although we have almost every war to date represented here today, there will be inevitably more to come. Some of you Boy Scouts, some of you young men and women, you're in fifth and sixth grade now. At some point in time in the future, you may be called to answer the call to defend this great nation, and you may have to give your life to do it. I pray that you don't, but I sincerely hope that you all have the courage and the commitment to do what needs to be done to preserve this great country. Thank you very much.